Reminds me, watching extra features for both Battlestar Galactica, the new show, not the original, but the new, and also Lost. The directors and the creators and producers all talking and making similar statements about how they listen to the creative ideas of their actors, because the actors have been playing the characters so long they started thinking about what the characters would want to do. And that's really cool, though.
Yeah,
Awesome.
I love the line when in the fourth episode of the first season, the walkabout episode, and they have the writer there, and the writer said, you know, at one point in the writing meeting, I just walked in and I said, I think John Locke was in a wheelchair when the plane crashed.
Yeah.
And that one idea has really gone
very far.
Very far. And genius, I've said this before, genius is not coming up with great ideas, it's recognizing great ideas when somebody says them, regardless of who it is.
Right.
Right. And that's an example of a great idea
Yes.
that went.
From St. Gulik, which is me. yes, I'm on Reddit. Let's see. You wrote Legend of Five Rings decades ago, and AEG has been publishing their own version for decades since then. Why should I play your new samurai RPG, Blood and Honor, instead of Legend of the Five Rings?
You shouldn't.
Okay.
If you like Legend of the Five Rings, you should play Legend of the Five Rings.
Right.
If you read Blood and Honor and you like it, you should play that. If you like Bushido, you should play that. If you like Sengoku, you should play that.
Right.
Right. I have a ton of samurai RPGs here.
Yes, you do.
And I learned from all of them. I learned things that I wanted to do, and I learned things that I didn't want to do. Right? Blood and Honor is a samurai role-playing game that's very different from Legend of the Five Rings.
Right.
That emphasizes the drama and tragedy of the samurai story over the fantastical, heroic
Samurai story.
samurai story, which is what Legend of the Five Rings is.
Right.
You can tell different stories with Blood and Honor than you can with L5R.
Right.
And vice versa.
Cool.
Right. So, but the big thing about Blood and Honor is that a lot of the ideas that are in it were ideas that I first had for Legend of the Five Rings, like the combat system. In Blood and Honor, if you get hit with a katana, you die.
Right, which is something I've heard you tell the story before, something that you guys had thought about originally for L5R, but
yeah.
got discarded because the idea of hit points and all that were
was really important.
Right.
And,
I can't recall a game that didn't have hit points back in the in those days of gaming.
Yeah.
I mean, everything had hit points. Buildings
yeah.
had hit points.
Yes. Chairs.
Exactly.
Yeah, and it was really came down to the idea of, I've told the story a million times, of how the Japanese would test katana on piles of criminals, right? And cut through the bodies and then etch onto the tsuba or whatever part of the sword that is, the number of bodies it cut through.
Right.
And now here's this katana. It's a four-man katana, and it's going to hit you.
Right.
Right.
With your wicker armor.
With your wicker armor. How many hit points do you have?
Right.
It's like
not that many.
It's like Godzilla steps on you. Oh, how many hit points do I take?
Right.
No.
Yeah, Cthulhu swallows 1d6 souls a round.
Yeah. Exactly. So what we did with L5R was we made it so that the hit points were so limited that it really didn't matter.
Right.
If you got hit with a katana, you were either dead or dying.
Yes.
So, there was that. And so we kind of cheated it.
Right.
But in Blood and Honor, the same rule is there. If you get hit with a katana, you die. The players have a community of honor points that they share.
Right.
I originally tried out doing the same thing I did with Legend of the Five Rings, which was have each player have honor.
Right.
But that meant that the players were acting individually and not as a clan.
Right.
Which is what
Blood and Honor
is about.
Right.
Is acting as a clan. So the clan, the community, shares the honor points. And if you use an honor point, you're
okay.
using everybody's honor point. And everyone looks at that honor point pool and is going, all right, do we...
Yeah.
If you screw up, you're costing me honor.
Right.
And that's how it should feel for samurai.
So you spend honor to...
You spend, when you get hit with a katana, you can spend honor to reduce the injury.
Right.
Which means you don't do what you're supposed to do, which was be ready to die at any moment.
Exactly.
And instead, an ingrate samurai would. Instead, you spend the honor to go, no, I'm going to live a little bit longer.
Right.
and probably die anyway. And
right.
you spent the honor anyway.
Right.
Coward.
Exactly.
So everything in Blood and Honor is about the clan.
Right.
So if players are interested in playing a clan, the big picture, the clan, through little stories about their samurai, that's what Blood and Honor is about.
Right.
And that's a really good example of how it works, is all the mechanics are community mechanics. They all share each other's stuff. And when one person screws up, everybody pays for it.
Right.
Because that's how a samurai game should work.
Right. Let me ask you another question about Blood and Honor. Is it set in a fantastical, strange world like Rokugan with the serial numbers scratched off? Or is this something different?
It's old Japan.
Okay.
So it is Japan.
Cool.
And there's going to be a map of Japan and the Japanese provinces and everything. But it's not historic Japan. It's the Japan of samurai literature.
Right.
So the samurai are, big, bold, and everything like that. And there is...
like an Akira Kurosawa
film. Like an Akira Kurosawa film.
Right.
It's based on actual historical guys.
Right.
But the guys in... I want to say Redbeard. No, in Throne of Blood, for example.
Right.
The characters in Throne of Blood are not historical.
Right.
But they are based on historical precedent. There's
right.
an actual samurai that fits the Macbeth storyline.
Right.
And Kurosawa used that to build from it.
Right.
And so it is old Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And if you wanted to, I suppose, you could take the mechanics from Blood and Honor and use them in different samurai settings.
Right.
But the main setting, and that's the other thing about Blood and Honor, is that I'm not taking really any time to explain samurai culture or anything like that, because
right.
I'm not an expert, and there are experts that you can get that are cheap, easy, and free.
Right. But you're not completely unaware of samurai culture.
No.
Okay.
There's a section of the player chapter called Etiquette That Matters.
Right.
And the Etiquette That Matters thing is about, for example, the whole thing about the samurai turning their sword up.
Right.
Right. A samurai would carry his sword blade down, but when he got pissed off, would turn it up so he could draw it out quickly. And that communicates something to the players, to the characters, and to the game master. It says, I'm pissed off.
Right.
It's a nonverbal way of communicating to the other players. And that's what Japanese etiquette should do.
Right.
When it matters, when it communicates something to the other players.
Right.
Going through the gifting ritual 100 billion times
right.
doesn't communicate anything.
Exactly.
Until, and I always use the Kachiko example of I would have the players go through the ritual a couple times so they got used to it. And then Kachiko would show up. Bayushi Kachiko from Legend of the Five Rings, and she would offer somebody a gift, and they would say, oh, I cannot accept this gift, and she would say, do not question my sincerity a second time.
Right.
And now the players are like, oh, what do I do? Should I do the proper thing, or should I do which? Ah, I don't know what to do. I'm in a socially awkward situation, which is where Kachiko wants you to be.
Exactly.
To start off the entire conversation in this awkward situation where you're second-guessing what to do. That communicates to the players. It creates something useful for the players and the game master to build from. Otherwise, it's just, minutia. It's
right.
It's like hit points.
Right, exactly.
You're doing it for the sake of doing it.